1919.
Bill's Beer Hall, a way station on the road to hell.
But my wife and the children!
Sit down, I said, or I'll ram these brass knuckles down your throat.
Now, hold on there, baby face. We can treat the gentleman better than that, can't we?
Well, he ain't been treating us so good, and I'm fed up! He's gonna get his face bashed in!
No, don't hurt him. He didn't mean to do us dirt. He's a nice guy. Aren't you Mr. Prinzmeyer?
Please, I have a wife and children. Please.
You see, he's a nice guy. He'll play along. The governor's going to give him another chance. Wait and see. What do you say, governor?
Please.
He have been warned 3 times already.
Governor, I appeal to you. Give the fellow a break. He's a good man. Why, he's even an elk.
Step out of way, Sammy. Mr. Pharmacist Prinzmeyer, I will explain to you once again. Do you wish your drug store to be protected from a criminal?
Yeah, yeah.
If you wish protection, then you must pay to us every month. Otherwise, who knows what may transpire.
But I have told you I have no money. Mine wife is dying sick woman.
Do not trifle with us, Mr. Pharmacist is unwise. Have you ever heard of the fly?
What is the fly?
If you miss payment, Mr. Pharmacist, they will come when mysterious woman in gray will stop you on street and ask for light for a cigarette. That is signal, Mr. Prinzmeyer. From that day on, you are marked man. When you light cigarette for the fly, flame of your life, soon snuff out.
Nine.
Reverend, please to show our friend her collection.
Ah, gee.
Hiya, Reverend.
Sorry, Governor, this contraption's awfully hot.
Sit down, you. When hat hung so high in air, Mr. Prinzmeyer, they have all been collected by our friend, Mr. Bill Crocker. Do you know him? Hiya, Reverend.
Extremely sorry.
When hat hung so high in air, head that once wore hat 6 feet on the ground. Do you wish to see your hat up there, Mr. Prinzmeyer?
Nine.
Then please to think again. Will you pay to us or no? Reverend, let us read answer on Mr. Prinzmeyer's face. Light, Reverend. Reverend.
I'm sorry, I can't hold this infernal thing a minute longer.
You dummy, why don't you grip it the way I show you? Hey, what are you doing?
How do you
light, Miriam. We try it one more time, gentlemen.
Oh,
and this time we get it right.
Well, can we take a break first? That light is killing my eyes.
If you put a handle on that damn reflector.
Well, if you would just hold it the way I showed you.
I have better things to worry about than your metallic imbecility.
We have all to worry about this.
Mr. Prinzmeyer is president of a mercantile association. If he refuses to make payment to us, they all refuse. We cannot countenance rebellion.
I got a new idea.
Well,
if you can work out a way to get them out of the room, let me talk to him alone.
It's too complicated.
Then I can work in my organ as a compromise offer.
Organ?
The church organ we picked up in the St. Luke's job last month. I ain't found a way of unloading it yet. I figure I can get old Prinzmeyer to buy it on time. That's how I'll get the...
Sammy! Please to keep your organ out of shakedown operation.
This is serious business.
Wire. Beer, Miriam.
Oh, Reverend, you wouldn't do that if Bill was...
Bill's here.
Where is Bill anyway?
Yeah, we need him for this job, you know.
That's right. Our threats won't mean diddly squat if we can't back him up.
So when is Bill getting back?
Yeah, what's taking him so long?
He better be here soon. Gentlemen, please.
Mr. Cracker will be here today. If not, he be replaced tomorrow. In any case, work will proceed. Flying has ordered. Lights!
Hey, the paper's here.
I got dibs on the funnies.
Hey, look at this. Baxley gang robs train.
Jeez.
Niagara Falls, New York Special Dispatch. Concerned citizens looked on in horror yesterday evening as the infamous Gorilla Baxley gang robbed the Chicago Buffalo Express train of over $20,000 in cash and gold bullion.
Bullion.
$20,000?
Little Bill hears about this.
This gang of bullies further outraged respectability continued on page 14. Huh?
Well, turn it, lunkhead.
By boarding the train at Niagara Falls,
disguised as a wedding party, this mockery of the Christian sacrament was compounded by the repulsive Baxley himself being costumed as the bride.
It is time, Shirley, for a new reign of law and order.
$20,000.
Bill's gonna explode.
Yeah, he hates Baxley's guts anyway.
Ah, Baxley, Baxley, Baxley. Why don't we get breaks like that?
Come, gentlemen, our turn yet to come.
Sure, like Christmas.
Do not mock, Reverend. Important news arrives soon.
That's right. The fly said we had a big job coming up.
Well, we all know her idea of a big job. Shaking down some crowd druggist for 6 bits and a bottle of Sloan's liniment. I ask you, what kind of professional crime is that?
Come out calm on troubled waters, Reverend.
Calm? This gang is so calm, it's got rigor mortis. You think it was impossible for a crook to earn a decent living, but it's not. Look at Gorilla Baxley. I have to admire a man like that. He has enterprise. He aims high. And as my sainted mother used to say, a man who aims high is a great man, not some penny-pushing gunslinger like our Bill. Gorilla Baxley is a great man. Gorilla Baxley is ambitious. Gorilla Baxley is imaginative. Gorilla Baxley is
dead.
Bill Cracker. His tough exterior concealed a heart of stone.
All right, Bill! Yeah.
That's time for you, Reverend. Yesterday a great man, today a little ink blot in the book of life. Thanks, sweetheart.
Oh, Bill!
A fine achievement, Bill! Congratulations! Fly ain't gonna like this at all.
Stick the fly. I can handle her. I can handle the both of you.
My friends, appropriate to a celebrate.
All right, Governor.
With the river out of way, Chicago, ours a two ride.
You said it.
Pillsbury Hall will be center of Annawar.
Yeah.
We'll be even greater place than original Pillsbury Hall in Bilbao.
Yeah. I never heard of it.
Then I'll tell you all about it.
Oh.
I'm not sure I remember all the words. But Bill can help out.
Right, Bill.
Thanks, but no thanks.
The
Bilbao song.
Bilsby Hall in Bilbao.
Bilbao?
Bilbao was the most fantastic place I've ever known. For just a dollar, you got all you wanted. All you wanted. All you wanted. Of whatever kind of joy you called your own. But if you had been around to watch the fun, well, I don't know if you had liked what you have seen. The stools at the bar were dead with rye. On the dance floor, the glass grew high. Through the roof, the moon was shining green. And the music really gave you some return on what you paid. Hey Joe, play that old song they always played. La da 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 da.
just too long ago.
Da 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 da.
I don't know if it would have brought your joy or grief, but it was fantastic. It was fantastic. It was fantastic. Beyond belief.
Bill's Beer Hall in Bilbao.
Bilbao. Bilbao.
Came a day the end of May in 1980. Four guys from Frisco came with sacks of gold dust. Sacks of gold dust! Sacks of gold dust!
Yeah.
And the time they showed us all was really great. But if you had been around to watch the fun, well, I don't know if you'd have liked what you'd have seen. The brandy bottles smashing everywhere! And the chairs flying through the air! Through the roof, the moon still shining green. And those four guys are going crazy with their pistols blazing high! Stop them, go right ahead and try.
Bow, Bilbao.
Down where we used to go.
Bow, Bilbao.
La da 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 da.
Bow, Bilbao.
Lord, never. Some people love it.
They've cleaned it up and made it middle class with potted palms and ice cream. Very bourgeois, very bourgeois. Just another place to put your ass. But if you should come around to see the fun, well, I don't know, you might not find it such a pain. They mopped up all the booze and broken glass. On parquet floors you can't grow grass. They've shut the green moon out because of rain. And the music makes you cringe now when you think of what you paid. Hey Joe, play that old song they always played.
That old Bilbao.
Down where we used to go.
Down where we used to go.
That old Bilbao moon.
That old Bilbao.
Casting its golden glow.
Casting its golden glow. That old Bilbao.
Love never laid me low.
Love never laid me low.
This old dame passed out in the street all of a sudden.
Hey, why, she's barely breathing.
Well, she might have broken an ankle or something. I better go get a cab to take her to the hospital.
Better move fast. It's rush hour.
Why?
God, what an ugly puss. What happened to you?
I tripped on a lump of dirt. Gorilla Baxley.
Gone?
G-O-N.
Very interesting. How you doing, baby face?
Not bad.
Item one. That bank job you've all been waiting for is scheduled for the day after tomorrow.
Christmas Eve!
Ho, ho, ho!
Brilliant!
Which bank?
You'll find out. Item two, last week's car heist. Well, Bill, you were gone a long time. We were getting worried.
Thanks for your concern. I got the cars to Detroit, fresh coat of paint, unloaded them real easy. We cleared $800. It's waiting in the usual place with receipts for my expenses.
Very good, Bill. Did you happen to run into Tessie Miller in Detroit?
What if I did?
Well, it doesn't really matter at all. It's just that I saw Tessie today. She had a new silver fox piece around her neck, Bill. She said it was a gift from a friend, Bill. She told me it cost $300, Bill.
300 clams, my.
300 clams. My.
Don't you wish you had friends like that?
Could you give me a light, Bill?
The fatal flame.
Governor! Remember that matter we discussed earlier?
Certainly.
We'll go ahead with that plan. Item three. You've rehearsed the Prince Meyer pharmacy job, right?
All set to go, boss!
Good. That $75 a month means a lot to us.
More chicken feed.
You can sit this one out, Bill. For the rest of you. Pharmacy is on the corner of Jackson and 15th. Sam and Baby, the back door. Professor, look out. Don't interrupt. Governor, you and the Reverend will take the front door. We are going to make a nice example of Mr. Prince Meyer. All right, you can have your rods back. It's time for the fly to buzz off.
Wait a minute, there's something else. What am I going to do about that goddamn church organ? I'm out $350.
You'll have to work that one out for yourself.
I'm back. I finally got a cab.
Is she all right?
Oh, she just seemed to be coming round.
Well, I better get her to the hospital.
I just want to say...
All right, lay off. What the hell you think this is, an old lady's home?
Yeah, but Bill, you don't understand what they want to try to...
Don't tell me I don't understand, Jocko. You think I don't know what's going on around here? You think I gotta read it in Braille? I ain't afraid to light no broad cigarette. I don't care what it means. And I can take you guys on one at a time or all together. So if any of you gimps wants to see your chapeaus up there above Dr. Wakasaki, you can meet me in the back room.
Well, we all know what we have to do. But how, may I ask, are we going to do it?
I don't know.
Of course not.
Lay off!
Now, there's got to be a way out of this. Let me think. Maybe you can think of some gadget that when he touches it, he bumps himself off.
Say, you know, that's not a bad idea. Now, let me see.
Gentlemen, not to worry. Mr. Crocker will be put out of way without any help from us. You recall minor job to be done this evening on unfortunate pharmacist.
Yes, sir. What?
Usually when we do such job, there is no evidence. Tonight will be evidence. Gentlemen, I give you and the police Mr. Cracker's revolver.
A veritable genius.
Hey, that ain't fair.
Very perceptive, baby face. Miriam! Beer.
Meanwhile, virtue mobilizes.
Look up around you. Look up around you. Look all around you. A man is about to drown. A woman is screaming, help me. A child is falling down. Don't move another step. Stop, stay right there. People need help all around you. Don't you even care? Are you completely blind? You've time to greet your brother, but none for all mankind. Forget about your dinner. Have you forgotten the sinner? How many stand in line? How many stand in line? I know you'll say the poor are always with us. Just and that's how it will stay. Here's how we answer you. You've got to stand up, forget your fears and march with us today. So bring on the tanks and the cannon, and squadrons of planes let there be, and battleships from the sea. Just to conquer one small bowl of soup for every poor man. Let every man come join us, our mission to fulfill. The army that is small but strong is made up of men of prepared.
Do you love your neighbor, sister?
Stop that, brother. A man can't love his fellow humans until he loves the Lord. We will sing to stir your souls. Number 5, Brother Hannibal, march ahead.
March ahead to the fight. Where Satan's power is at its height. Sing we know, use your might. Let your song ring through the night. Soon you'll see the morning light. And with the Lord in the Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, it's kind of catchy.
Oh, sister, you have moved me. I should like to repent.
A convert already.
It's about time we saw you praying, Reverend.
Shame on you, brother, shame. This man wants to forsake his life of sin, and you just laugh.
Pay no attention to them, sister. Your singing, it does my heart good.
Hallelujah, brother.
I am a miserable sinner.
Yes.
But I feel comfort in the presence of a holy person such as yourself.
Brother.
Oh, brother.
I feel I can confide in you, sister. Sister, what is your name, sister?
And what's your telephone number?
I am Sister Lillian Holliday.
Sister Lillian!
How do you do, Sister Lillian?
And this is Sister Mary, Sister Jane, Brother Ben Owens, and Brother Hannibal Jackson with the tambourine.
Oh!
She's the one they call Hallelujah Lil, the saint of South Canal Street.
Mosque, edifying.
She's got some build on her for a saint.
Don't mind them, Sister Lillian. Let me tell you my story. I was brought up without benefit of your divine guidance. My ma, rest her soul, kept me alive by selling her body. And when she died, my dad sold it again to the medical students. All for my sake. It's true, sister. And as a consequence, it was inevitable that my hands should have to raid onto other people's property for a rather large proportion of my life.
Oh, not so, brother.
Oh, not when the blessed army is here to rescue me, sister.
For I deeply repent the error of my ways now that I feel closer to you and to God. My remorse is great.
Ain't it the truth?
But I want to make a clean breast of my sins. I want to donate all of my ill-gotten gains to the cause.
We know the saying, there is more joy in heaven
over us than there is over you for sure. So here's my contribution.
Shame on you, brother, shame. I have had enough. I'm going to preach you a sermon.
Oh, boy, now look what you got us in for.
The topic of today's sermon, brothers, is the rat. Isaiah 66:17. The abomination and the rat, they shall come to an end together, saith the Lord.
Amen.
Now, I think you all know what a rat is. It's a dirty little animal that lives in the worst part of town.
Here we is, sweetheart.
A rat is a troublemaker, brothers. A rat stinks of garbage the way a drunken man stinks of whiskey. A rat carries disease as a hoodlum carries his gun and blackjack.
Easy there, sister.
He lives in the darkest, dirtiest holes he can find. He hides from the good people who live in the poor parts of town, the ones who only want to live right and walk decent with their lord.
Wait a minute.
Because that's not what a rat wants, brothers.
And what does he want, dollface?
He wants to live off those good people. He wants to creep out of his hole when they're not looking. And he wants to steal the bread from their mouths.
Amen.
And that's why decent people hate rats. And you are rats.
Now, I never looked at it in that light before.
But there's a way out for the rat, brothers.
Yeah, what?
The rat could reform.
Could he not?
Clean himself up.
I'll bet.
Come out of his hole and get a decent job, so to speak.
And be a decent church mouse?
Yes, he could, brother, he could. But he doesn't.
Oh, too bad.
Do you know why he doesn't?
No, why, beautiful?
Because he's afraid. Yes, brothers. The rat is a coward. It doesn't take courage to commit his crimes. Just a shortage of policemen. And a dark street, but he's afraid to come in out of the darkness because he's got no faith. He thinks the whole world's made up of rats like him because a rat who knifes a good man in the back on Monday will knife his brother rat on Tuesday. So don't be a rat. Don't live in fear and darkness. Come into the light of Jesus and live decent because the rats will turn against you in the end. But Jesus is always with you.
I'm with you, baby.
Get your meat hooks off her.
Jesus, Bill. I'm sorry.
You get these holy rollers out of here and fast.
Kill her! Come, sisters. We've been wasting our time.
Wait! Take me with you. Get me out of this awful place.
All right, you Benedict Donald. Get out of here, all of you, before I throw you out.
Well, I'm staying.
Oh, you are you?
Brother Hannibal, if I'm not back in 2 hours, bring help.
God go with you, sister. And preserve me from the migraine I'm getting.
So, you're staying.
You may be the notorious Bill Cracker. But you don't frighten me.
Don't I?
King Nebuchadnezzar was a bigger crook than you. And he didn't frighten Daniel.
King who?
Nebuchadnezzar. He ruled his gang with an iron fist, but even he couldn't stand up to God. And when it was over, they threw him out, and he had nothing but grass to eat.
Can we get you a plate of grass, Bill?
Shut up! Hey, don't you boys got a job to do or something? Beat it while your shoes are good.
Only too glad to oblige, Bill.
Hey, Bill!
wise, Babyface. Good night, Miss Hallelujah Lillian. Goodbye, Mr. William Cracker.
The bums. You gotta sew your pockets shut to keep their hands out. Sit down. Now tell me about this king what ate the grass. What was his name?
Nebuchadnezzar.
Likewise.
When the army of the Lord does battle, Cupid often calls the shots.
You've got it all wrong. You've misjudged us. Admit it. You've had the wrong idea of us all these years. Just like that king had a Daniel. The one who ate grass. What was his name?
Nebuchadnezzar.
Right! He repented of his ways and joined the Salvation Army. And that's what you should do, too.
Maybe I should.
You're wasting your life. You don't need murder, theft, hard liquor to keep you happy. The army is always happy. It's music and light and joy. That's why I came to work there, for the joy. I want to see people happy. And so does the army.
You want them to be happy your way?
No. I keep telling you. You've got it all wrong. We're not afraid to see things your way.
All that drum beating? And those songs about Jesus.
We have songs that don't have anything to do with Jesus.
Yeah, I can guess what they're like.
Bet you can't. I need a hat for this one. Have you got a sailor hat? Oh, now, this is a common song about the life of common sailors. Listen.
The Sailor's Tango.
Hey there, we're sailing off to Burma this evening with enough good scotch on board to float all the way, plus a crate of great cigars. Henry Clay had it up to here with girls, so we're leaving, 'cause it's time to start a brand new day. Yeah, it's time to start a brand new day. Now we don't ever smoke other brands of cigars, and this leaky tub will barely get us to Burma. And we don't need that god who's up there in the stars, and we don't need all his laws on terra firma. So right, goodbye, and the ship sails away, and it may reach Rangoon. And as for God, well, we don't get him. And it may be that God feels just the same about us, so let's hope he doesn't let it upset him. So, all right, goodbye. We're off from the 'cause there's not a thing we have to do. No, there's not a thing we have to do. Now we never smoke cigars that cost less than 5 cents, and that cheap black bread gives us indigestion. And we don't give a damn what makes other guys tense. And as for soul searching, there's just no question. That's not why we're here, and our life sails away, and who knows how it ends. And as for God, well, let's forget him. And it may be that God feels just the same about us, so let's hope he won't let it upset him. Yeah, why should he care? Just a bank of black clouds in the air. Jesus, and the waves are going crazy out there. Jesus, in a minute, the whole lot of us will be dead. Well, we knew we'd have to die somewhere. Yeah, we knew we'd have to die somewhere. The ship, and soon the sea washes over. Nothing but sharks down there to show a drowned man his way. Scotch is no use to them, or crates of Henry Clay. Where they're going, there are no girls who need a lover. They won't ever see another day. They won't ever see another day. And the water comes up, and the ship's going down. And as for a harbor, we don't get one. Just a wreck of a ship and a glimpse of a shore. But of course, one can't let it upset one. So write goodbye, then for once you don't hear all that big talk in the air. And the big talkers suddenly look smaller. And they're down on their knees and mumbling about their father who's up there. And they're starting to weigh the sins their souls must bear. And that's how they die. And now let me tell you a fact that we all ought to know. When you stand before the throne where our Lord is sitting, you may have been bragging a lifetime or so. But now, when it matters, you're shitting. Oh, the sea is blue, so blue. And all the world goes on its way. When your day is over, and there is no other day. Oh, the sea is blue, so blue, and that's how it's gonna stay. Oh, the sea is blue, so blue. Oh, the sea is blue, so blue. Oh, the sea is blue, so blue. sermon to the sinner.
A sermon? To one man?
What was your text?
Take off that hat. You look ridiculous.
And what is that on your breath? This is scandalous.
It really is shocking.
I'm reporting you to the major. Shame, Lillian.
Lay off, creep.
And you keep out of this. You don't have your gang of roughnecks here now to threaten us. Come on, Lillian.
I have to go eat my grass now.
Are you Bill Cracker?
Certainly not.
I'm Cracker, Hawkshaw. What's your problem?
Where were you at 7 o'clock this evening?
I was here.
Any witnesses?
Her.
Just her. Miss, were you and this man alone here at 7 o'clock this evening?
7 o'clock?
A little more than an hour ago.
Alone here?
Think of the scandal.
Well, I was here. Then there were some others with us. And then we all left, and I just came back just now.
I see. Bill Cracker, you're under arrest for the murder of Jacob Prinsmeyer, pharmacist, at 7 o'clock this evening. They found your gun at the scene.
So that's it. You liked her cigarette, and wham!
Smoking cigarettes, too.